I just turned a discarded piece of wood into a wire stripping tool that works even better than the ones you buy at the store. I tried turning it into a homemade wire stripping tool, and the results exceeded my expectations. With just a few simple steps and a small metal blade, the rough piece of wood instantly became a precise, compact, and highly practical tool. If you enjoy simple yet effective DIY hacks, this is definitely something you'll want to try right away. I grabbed a bold tip marker and dragged it straight along the length of the wood, creating a reference line running from one end to the other. This line acts as a cutting guide, ensuring that when the piece is split in half, both sections come out straight, flat, and perfectly aligned. After marking all the spots that needed to be carved exactly as shown in the video, I moved straight to the wood cutting step. I set the piece of wood onto the vise to secure it, then aligned the saw blade precisely with the marked line. Once the cut reached a sufficient depth, the wood began to open slightly along the saw line, and I simply continued cutting through until it split completely. This is a critical shaping step, ensuring that both halves are straight, flat, and ready for the groove cutting and blade installation stages that come next. After splitting the piece in half, I noticed that the cut surfaces were still quite rough, with saw teeth marks left behind. To make the surfaces smoother and cleaner, I took a sheet of medium grit sandpaper, pressed it against the cut, and began sanding along the wood grain. After sanding, the cut surfaces were flat, smooth, and free of bumps or leftover fragments. The two halves fit together perfectly, providing a solid foundation for carving the wire guiding groove. Next, I prepare a small hinge to join the two halves of the wood. I position the hinge along the outer edge, making sure both halves would still fit snugly when closed, and then mark the screw positions. After drilling the holes, I took the screws and fastened the hinge securely into the wood. I turned the screwdriver steadily, ensuring the screws were tight without cracking the surface. Once all the screws were in place, the hinge was firmly attached, and the two halves could open and close smoothly without any looseness or wobble. At this point, the wooden frame was stable, providing the perfect foundation for carving the wire guiding groove and installing the metal blade to turn it into a wire stripping tool. Next, I drilled a hole right down the center of the two wooden halves, following the previously marked center line. This hole would serve as a starting point for carving the wire guiding groove, allowing the wire to pass through smoothly without slipping. I held the two halves firmly while drilling, working slowly to ensure a straight, clean hole without chipping the surrounding wood. Once the center hole was complete, I had a solid base for carving the groove, preparing for the installation of the metal blade and precise, safe completion of the wire stripping tool. After drilling the center hole, I use a slender file to smooth out the groove I had created. Each filing motion was steady, following the length of the groove to remove sharp edges. Left over were fragments, and to make the inner surface flat and even, I frequently checked by hand to ensure the groove wasn't too deep or misaligned. Once filing was complete, the groove became uniform and smooth, ready for the wire to pass through easily, making the wire stripping tool precise, safe, and highly effective. After marking, I carved the groove along the line I had drawn. Instead of buying a new blade, I decided to repurpose an old utility knife blade I had on hand. The thin, sharp blade fit perfectly into the groove I had carved, making it ideal for the main cutting part of the wire stripping tool. I placed the blade into the groove and carefully checked the fit, ensuring it wasn't crooked or loose. After placing the utility knife blade into the groove, I used hot glue to secure it firmly. I applied just enough glue into the groove, pressing the blade tightly so it adhered securely to the wood without shifting. Once the glue cooled and hardened completely, I used pliers to snap off the excess blade protruding beyond the groove, leaving only the portion needed to cut the wire. After snapping off the excess blade, I used a small file to smooth the freshly cut edge. This removed any sharp corners and leftover metal fragments. Creating a smoother surface and preventing scratches when handling wires. I prepared a mixture of baking soda and super glue to cover the back of the blade, where it might protrude or pose a risk during use. This mixture hardens quickly, forming a solid protective layer that not only further secures the blade, but also reduces the risk of scratches when handling the tool. Once fully dried, the back of the blade was safely covered, making the wire stripping tool both effective and maximally safe to use. After all the steps, the wire stripping tool made from the piece of wood was finally complete. The two halves fit snugly thanks to the hinge, the wire guiding groove was smooth, the utility knife blade securely fixed, and the back protected with the glue baking soda mixture. It felt solid in hand, operated smoothly, and was ready for testing. I took a piece of wire, placed in the groove, and gently pulled it through the blade. And immediately, the plastic insulation came off cleanly, leaving the internal wires intact. A piece of wood that once seemed like trash had now been transformed into a compact, effective, and highly practical DIY tool. As I pulled the wire through the tool, The cutting action was smooth and consistent. The plastic insulation peeled off evenly, without tearing or scratching the copper core, showing that the blade was firmly secured and the wire guiding groove worked precisely. With each pull, the wire ran straight through the groove without drifting to either side, giving a complete sense of control. While I'm at it, I'll show you a great trick with copper wire. So I'm going to use something as a filler or buffer, then pull the wire through, and it works perfectly. I took this piece of copper wire and tightly wound it around the shaft with an iron nail, making several close coils to increase the wire density. When both ends of the wire are connected to a battery, the current flowing through generates a magnetic field, turning the ordinary nail into a temporary electromagnet. If you want it to attract more strongly, there are several ways to enhance it. Increasing the number of wire coils around the nail will amplify the magnetic field, while using thicker wire allows more current to flow without overheating, strengthening the electromagnet. A higher voltage battery, within safe limits, will also boost the current, further increasing the magnetic force. Choosing a larger or softer iron core, such as a longer or more magnetically receptive nail, can enhance the field even more. When I brought the wire-wrapped nail connected to the battery close to the paper clips, they were instantly attracted to the nail. They clung tightly to its shaft and stacked on top of each other. After all the steps, the wire stripping tool made from the piece of wood was complete and ready to use. It feels solid in hand, operates smoothly, the wire guiding groove is smooth, and the blade is securely fixed, allowing the plastic insulation to be removed quickly without damaging the copper core. With just a simple material that seemed like trash, I created a compact, effective, and safe DIY tool, perfectly suited for any household electrical project. Now, stripping wires is easier, more precise, and even more fun than ever. If you have any fun DIY ideas, clever tips, or creative experiments you want to try, leave a comment below. I'd love to see your ideas and explore new things together.